Hello friends, welcome to TechStudySell. In this video, we will make a very useful IoT project using the ESP32. I have received a lot of requests to add fan speed control with my existing IoT projects. So in this video, we will discuss how to control the fan speed through internet using the Blynk IoT platform. And if there is no internet, still you can control the fan speed with IR remote and a manual selector switch. Apart from that, you can also control 4 appliances with the Blynk IoT app, IR remote and manual switches. And the most important part of this project that ESP32 can also remember the last GPIO states. So after power failure, when the ESP32 will restart, the appliances will automatically turn on according to the previous states. So this is a very useful IoT project, and as you can see, you can make the complete circuit without using any PCB. And during the video, I have explained how to connect a 4-step regulator with relays to control the fan speed through internet. And I have also explained the circuit source code, so after watching the video, you can easily make this project for your home. So without any further delay, let's get started. These are the required components for this project. To control the speed of the fan, either you can use a 4-step regulator or you can also make the complete circuit on the zero PCB. In this video, I'm going to use this 4-step regulator. So if I remove the top cover, you will find a selector switch. Then if you desolder the selector switch, you can see the marking on the selector switch. This is common. This is 1, 2, 3. In this way, you can also identify the step on this small PCB. This is the common. Then this is the 1, 2, 3, 4. After that, I can connect this selector switch with the ESP32 to control the speed of the fan manually. And I can connect this PCB with the relays. Now we have to connect all these components as per this circuit diagram. In the circuit, I have given the 5-volt supply to ESP32 relay module and the sensors. With the first 4 relay, we are controlling these 4 lamps. Then with the 5th, 6th and 7th relay, we are controlling the speed of the fan. And this is the 4-step regulator connected with the ESP32. Now if we select step 1 in the regulator, then the 5th relay will turn on and current can flow through this path. Then for the step 2, 6th relay will turn on and current can flow through this path. Then for the step 3, both the 5th and 6th relay will turn on together and current can flow through these 2 paths. After that, for the 4th step, the 7th relay will turn on. And as you can see, there is no resistance in this path, so fan will rotate in the full speed. And with these latch switches, we can control these 4 lamps manually. And for this project, although I have used the 8 channel relay module, but here I have used only 7 relays. And if you want to use push button, then you can refer this circuit. Please take proper safety precaution while connecting the AC appliances and the fan regulator circuit with the relay module. And as I said, for this regulator circuit, either you can use a 4-step regulator or you can make this regulator circuit on the zero PCB. This is the complete circuit. I have made the complete circuit on the zero PCB. So here you can see these latch switches are connected with the ESP32, and this is the common ground. Let me show you. This is the common ground, and these pins are connected with the ESP32 GPIO, and this is the 4-step selector switch from the regulator, and the pins are also connected with the ESP32 GPIO, and this is the IR receiver and the DST11 sensor. And this is the 8 channel relay module also connected with the ESP32 GPIO. And this is the fan regulator circuit. The first 4 relay connected with these 4 lamps. And the 5th, 6th and 7th relay are connected with the regulator circuit. So here you can see I have also marked the step on this PCB. So this blue wire is connected with the step 1 and this blue wire is connected with the 5th relay. Then this green wire is connected with the step 2 and this wire is connected with the 6th relay. Here you can see it is connected with the 6th relay. And this yellow wire connected with the step 4 and it is connected with the 7th relay. So you need to connect this 3 wire to connect this regulator circuit with this 5th, 6th and 7th relay, and this wire will go to fan. Here you can see this black wire is coming from the ceiling fan. So the circuit is very simple. You can make the circuit without using PCB, but if you don't want to make the complete circuit on this zero PCB, you can use this PCB for the circuit. You can easily connect the relay module with this PCB. Here you can see, you can just connect the relay module with the ESP32 in this way and control these relays from this button. You can also connect the sensors and latch switch with this pin. So if you want to use this PCB, you can download the Garber file from the video description and order it from the JLC PCB. In JLC PCB, you can also use their PCB assembly service absolutely free. You just have to pay for the components. To use their PCB assembly service, you have to generate three files. You have to generate the PCB Garber file, then BOM file, and at last beacon place file. Then visit the JLC PCB. You can find the link in the description. Then you have to upload the Garber file. After that, I will scroll down. Now I want all the components should be soldered on the top side of the PCB. Now I have to upload the BOM file and pick and place file. So here you have to confirm all the components that you want to use for the SMT service. So you can see they are showing approx footprint and you will get all the details here. After checking all this, click on save to cart and place the order. And in my case, I have received this PCB from JLC PCB within a week, and as you can see, the packing is really good and also the quality is very premium in this affordable price. And I'm also designing a PCB to make this complete circuit on a single PCB. Once done, I will share the Garber file of that PCB in the video description. Now we have to configure the Blynk account for this project. Now let me go to template. Here I am going to duplicate this template. I have created this template in one of my previous video. You can find a video link in the description. I will just click on duplicate. Then I will go to data stream. In my previous video, I have explained how to add data stream in the template. Please refer my previous video. For this project, I just have to add one more data stream to control the speed of the fan. So I will go to new data stream and select the virtual pin. Then here I will give the name fan regulator. In the pin, I will select V0 virtual pin. Now as I am going to use a 4-step fan regulator, so I have selected the minimum value 0, maximum value will be 4, and default value will be 0. Now I will click on create. So here you can see we have added this fan regulator data stream. Now if you want, you can also add automation to this Blynk project. Now in the web dashboard, I will just add a slider to control the speed of the fan. If I go to the setting, then here I will give the name fan regulator. Then in the data stream, I will select V0 pin. Now I will click on save. Let me resize it. Now I will click on save. So our Blynk template for this project is ready. Now we will quickly add the device using this template. So I will click here. Then I will click on new device. Then I will select from template. Then select the template we have just created. And here you can also give the name for the device. Then click on create. So our device is added. Let me go to device info. And here you will get all the details which will be required for coding. These are the source code for this project. You can download all these codes from our website iotcircuithub.com. Just visit the article link given in the description. Then you can download all the codes from these buttons. After downloading, you can use this code to get the hex code of the IR remote buttons. And again, I have explained the process in my previous video. You can find the link in the description. Then if you want to use push button, then you can refer this code, and for the latch switch, you have to use this code. Let me open the code for the latch switches. For this project, you have to install all these libraries. I have also mentioned the version of the library I have used. So please install this version only. Then you have to enter the template ID, device name and authentication token. For that, I will go to Blynk Cloud account, and under the device info, you will get all these details. Just click here to copy all these details, and here I have to paste it. After that, you have to enter the Wi-Fi name
and the Wi-Fi password. Then here you have to update the hex code of the IR remote buttons. Now if you refer the same circuit, then after doing these changes, you can directly upload the code to ESP32. For that, go to Tools, select the board as Do It ESP32 Dev Kit V1, then select the proper port, then hit the upload button. Let me quickly explain how the code works. These are the GPIO pins I have used for this project. These 4 GPIO pins are connected with the 4-step selector switch, and these are the virtual pins I have used to create the data streams in the Blynk account. Now let me go to the void setup. In the void setup, first I am opening a namespace in read-write mode in the ESP32 flash memory to save the current states of the relays. Then I am calling this function to fetch the previous state from the ESP32 flash memory. In the void loop, we are calling this tree function. With this function, we can control the relays with the manual switches. Then with this function, we can manually control the speed of the fan with the 4-step selector switch. Then with this IR remote function, we can control all the appliances with the IR remote. Now let me explain this fan regulator function. If all the GPIO pins connected with the selector switch is high, then the current speed will be 0 and it will call this function with this current speed variable. Then if we select step 1 in the selector switch, then only this GPIO pin will connect with the ground, so it will become low. Then the current speed will be 1 and again it will call this fan speed control function with this current speed variable. Now let me go to the fan speed control function. With this function, we can control the speed of the fan. So this function received an integer value. So if the integer value is 0, it will turn off all the relays connected with the regulator circuit. So if the integer value received is 1, then first it will turn off all the relays. Then after 500 millisecond delay, it will turn on the 5th relay. If it received 2, then again it will turn off all the relays for 500 millisecond. After that, it will turn on the 6th relay. Here I have used active low relay module. So to turn on the relay module, I have to send low signal, and for the high signal, the relay will turn off. Now let me go to the IR remote function. In the IR remote function, first we are checking if there is any data available from the IR receiver. Then we are comparing the data with the predefined hex code. So to control the speed of the fan, I have used these 2 hex code. If it receives this hex code, then it will increase the speed of the fan. Again, I am calling this fan speed control function with this current speed variable. And if it receives this hex code, then it will decrease the fan speed by 1. So if you go through the code, you can easily understand. Still, if you faced any issue, you can always let me know in the comment section.
Now we will quickly configure the mobile dashboard. Let me open the Blynk IoT app. So this is our device we have added. So this is the mobile dashboard I have already created during my previous video. Again, link in description. Now I will tap this edit icon, and now to control the speed of the fan, I will add a slider. So again, I will tap on this plus icon and then I will add this slider. Let me place this slider at the bottom. Now I will tap on the slider widget, and here I will select the data stream V0. So we have added this fan regulator data stream to control the speed of the fan. If you go to design, you can also give the name for this slider. Let me give fan regulator. Now let me exit from this widget. So our dashboard is ready. Let me exit from the edit mode. Now let me connect this ESP32 with the circuit. As you can see, our circuit is ready. First, let me control the appliances with the Blynk IoT app. Next, I will use this IR remote to control these lamps. And you can also use this manual switch to control the lamps. Now I will use this selector switch to increase the fan speed. If I select step 1, you can monitor the slider in the Blynk IoT app. Then I will select step 2. In this way, I can increase or decrease the fan speed with this selector switch. And I can also use the IR remote to control the fan speed. If I press this button, you can see the slider value increase. And if I press this button, the fan speed will decrease. You can see in the slider. And you can use this button to turn off all the lamps and fan together. If you find this video helpful, then please hit the like button, and I will really appreciate if you can support our work on Patreon. You can find the link in the description. Don't forget to subscribe for more such videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.